The Articles of Confederation, reading on page 222 and 223, Ideas About Government. The American colonies had taken a bold step in declaring their independence from Great Britain in July 1776. Their next political goal was to form new governments. To do so, the American people drew from a wide range of political ideas. One source of information was English law. England had limited the power of its kings and queens in two documents, Magna Carta and the English Bill of Rights. Magna Carta, signed by King John in 1215, required the king to follow the rule of law like other English people. The English Bill of Rights, passed in 1689, kept the king or queen from passing new taxes or changing laws without Parliament's approval. As a result, the people's representatives had a stronger voice in government. Americans were also influenced by the Enlightenment. Writers of that period had called for the use of reason and expressed a belief in human goodness. Enlightenment philosopher John Locke believed that a society contract or agreement existed between political leaders and the people they ruled. One side of this contract was the government's duty to protect the people's inalienable rights. The rule of law, wrote Locke, was more important than the authority of any individual. Locke stated that leaders who broke the law or lost the approval of the people should be replaced. Naturally, American leaders looked to their own political traditions, such as the New England town meeting. At these meetings, townspeople addressed important issues in their community. Americans also looked to their own legislative assemblies, such as the Virginia House of Burgesses. These bodies offered models of representative governments. Christian traditions, such as the Great Awakening, may have also inspired colonists to question existing political institutions and look for a more local control. Turn the page. Americans also had written documents supporting the principles of self-government. In 1620, the Pilgrims had agreed to govern themselves at Plymouth Colony by signing the Mayflower Compact. In 1639, the people of Connecticut had drawn up the Fundamental Orders of Connecticut. This plan was widely considered to be the first written constitution in the English colonies. A constitution is a set of basic principles and laws that state the powers and duties of the government. Finally, the Declaration of Independence clearly set forth the ideas on which Americans thought government should be based.